हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर सेवन्थ ऑफ साइंस ऑफ क्लास सेवन्थ, दैट इज वेदर क्लाइमेट एंड एडेप्टेशन ऑफ एनिमल्स टू क्लाइमेट। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द वेदर एंड क्लाइमेट। वी विल ऑल्सो सी हाउ डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ लाइफ आर अडेप्टेड टू द क्लाइमेट ऑफ देयर हैबिटेट। So we will study about climate and adaptation of animals to climate, where we will study about polar areas and tropical rainforest. Weather is such a complex phenomenon that it can vary over very short periods of time. It can happen sometimes that it is sunny in the morning, but suddenly clouds appear from nowhere and it starts raining heavily, or a heavy rain may vanish in a matter of minutes and give way to bright sunshine. You must have had several such experiences. Since weather is such a complex phenomenon, it is not easy to predict. Students, do you remember the things that you were asked to pack when you were heading for a hill station? When the sky is cloudy, your parents insist that you carry an umbrella. Have you heard elders in your family discuss the weather before planning a family function? You must have also heard the expert discussing the weather before the start of a game. Have you ever wondered why the weather may have a profound effect on the game? It has a profound effect on our lives. Many of our daily activities are planned based on the weather predicted for that day. There are daily reports of the weather on the televisions and radio and in the newspaper. The day-to-day condition of the atmosphere at the place with respect to the temperature, humidity, rainfall, wind speed, etc. is called the weather at that place. Students, weather of a place is never constant. It changes hour after hour, day after day, and week after week. That is why we often say today's weather is too humid or the weather was warm last week. Temperature, humidity, that is amount of moisture in air, rainfall and wind speed are called the elements of the weather. Students, we find that the hourly, daily, weekly, monthly report about weather. The weather report carries information about the temperature, humidity, as you might know, is a measure of the moisture in air, and wind speed, rainfall, time of sunrise and sunset. Students, you must be thinking that who prepares these reports? The weather reports are prepared by the meteorological department of the government. The department collects data on temperature, rainfall, wind, etc. and makes the weather prediction. Students, you can see a sample of weather report from a newspaper that is given in your textbook of science on page number 68. Students, in this sample, the maximum temperature is 16.1 degrees Celsius and the minimum temperature is 2.6 degrees Celsius. The time of sunset on Tuesday is 5:41 p.m. and the time of sunrise on Wednesday is 7:15 a.m. And the time of moonset on Wednesday is 11:13 a.m. And the time of moonrise on Tuesday is 11:05 p.m. Mist or fog in the morning, partially cloudy sky, minimum temperature will be around 4 degrees Celsius and maximum humidity on Monday 83% and minimum humidity 37%. Bozo wonder why weather changes so frequently. And Paheli wants to know what is the source of weather in the first place. So, all changes in the weather are caused by the sun. The sun is a huge sphere of hot gases at a very high temperature. The distance of the sun from us is very large. Even then, the energy sent out by the sun is so huge that it is the source of all heat and light on the earth. So, the sun is the primary source of energy that causes changes in the weather. Energy absorbed and reflected by the earth's surface, oceans, and the atmosphere play important roles in determining the weather at any place. If you live near the sea, you would have realized that the weather at your place is different from that of a place in a desert or near a mountain. So, student, this is clear. All changes in the weather are caused by the sun. And sun is the primary source of energy that causes changes in the weather. Students, you can see the graph that is given in your textbook on page number 70. The graph shows the maximum temperature recording during 3rd August 2006 to 9th August 2006 at Shillong, Meghalaya. So, students, you can see the maximum temperature on 3rd August is 26 degrees Celsius. On 4th August is 23.5 degrees Celsius. On 5th August is 25 degrees Celsius. On 6th August is 22 degrees Celsius. On 7th August is 25.5 degrees Celsius. On 8th August is 23.3 degrees Celsius. And on 9th August is 24.4 degrees Celsius. So, students, you can see the temperature is not the same on any 2 days. So, we can say that maximum temperature is different in all the days of the week. So, students, as it is clear from any weather report, the maximum and minimum temperatures are recorded every day. Do you know how these temperatures are recorded? In chapter 4, you have learned that there are special thermometers for this purpose called maximum and minimum thermometer. The maximum temperature of the day occurs generally in the afternoon, while the minimum temperature occurs generally in the early morning. Students, rainfall is measured by an instrument called the rain gauge. It is basically a measuring cylinder with a funnel on top to collect rainwater. You can see in the picture. And humidity, that is amount of moisture in air, is measured by psychrometer. And wind speed is measured by anemometer. You can see the picture of anemometer and psychrometer. Students, you have to do activity 7.1 by yourself. Students, you have to cut out the weather reports of the last week from any newspaper. If you do not get a newspaper at home, borrow from your neighbors or friend. And now record the information from the weather reports collected by you in table 7.1. So students, you have to complete table 7.1 by yourself. So students, we will study about climate in next video. Up till then, thank you.